Pushpak was released in 1988, and after that, Kamal Hassan and myself, we were discussing the next project for Rajkamal International, that is Kamal Hassan's own production. And at that time, I did two Dr. Rajkumar's films, that unit. And by the time I finished those two films, they were also released in 1988. One day, Mr. Kamal Hassan came out with an idea. He did a small bit role in one Mr. Balachandra's film as a dwarf. So that worked. It was a very small bit and just like an experiment. But he told me, now that seems to work. And supposing we expand it into a full-fledged film, then how is it? I immediately accepted because I jumped at the idea. A hero doing the entire film as a dwarf is something exciting. So I wanted to do it, and I said immediately we'll start on the script. And the problems will be there, how to play the dwarf. That he said there is no problem. It is only thing is, it is a challenge, and I would love to take those responsibilities, take those challenges and work hard. But we'll have to make the film. And for the first time, Mr. Crazy Mohan, he had come to write the script. And Mr. Anantu was always there throughout. He is our big support. And myself, Kamal Hassan, Crazy Mohan and Anantu, we started working on the script. And Mr. Kamal Hassan came with a small, short line. And we developed on it, where he is a dwarf. And there are two heroines. And he loves both. We do not know whom he loves and all that. And both give an impression that they are loving him. But it is only a game they are doing. And finally, they have got some other lovers. And he goes away in the desert because he is a clown in a circus. Na ni na 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 ni na na. Like that, he will be singing on a camels and a caravan. He will be going away. That will be the end. So it is a sight of a emotional, sensitive type of film, we thought. And at that time, we thought it was okay. Immediately, we started shooting. I think Mr. Rajkumar, they all came, Mr. Balachandra, they all came to give the clap in some studios. I do not know whether this film or some film, but anyway, it started. And we did about 8 or 9 days of shooting, quite vigorous. We tried to do a bit of this dwarf's ring and the experiment. And Mr. P.C. Sriram was the cameraman. Mr. Ilayaraja was the music director. And Mr. Lenin was the editor. So, after 8 or 9 days, I had a doubt whether this film was working. Mr. Kamal Hassan was a star, big star by that time. And Mr. Kamal Hassan, everybody thinks he is a romantic hero, girls must love him, he must love him. It's a different type of image he is having. So they don't love him, they just play with him and do it. It may be a realistic film, but will it work commercially? I had a doubt and I called Mr. Kamal Hassan. He agreed. Then we all started thinking. This way, we said, Anantu showed some other idea, Crazy Mohan said some other idea, but nothing was working. So Mr. Kamal Hassan himself thought, Mr. Panju Arunachalam, he is very clear in his mind. Of course, there is a joke also. Mr. Panju Arunachalam is a very good critic of other people's films. Wherever you go and tell him about a story, he will immediately analyze and correct it. But unfortunately, I do not know why that sort of a decision making doesn't come to his films. Most of the films, there are somewhere there were he was making a mistake. But in others' films, he was usually very correct, almost correct. So we called him and we told him the story. He said, give me 2 days' time. I will think it over and come. So he came back after 2 days and he said, now, you have a wonderful character in the dwarf. Because everybody will wonder how you make this dwarf. And I expect that you will make it perfectly. He will look like a dwarf. How you are going to make, I do not know. But this is a perfect character. He is the hero. But that hero will go to heights. Provide him, we make him a hero who achieves something. not somebody who just goes off in a caravan disappointed because two girls did not like him. That won't work at all. It is sure it won't work. So what he suggested is, we will make it a double role. It was Mr. Panju Arunachalam who suggested this. One is a normal person, it is a twins. For some circumstances which we develop, the other person is born as a dwarf and the father is killed. He is a police officer. That also he told in this narration. He is a killed. And now as they grow, they come to know the story. They want to, the dwarf comes to know the story, he wants to take vengeance on these people. He wants to avenge the death of his father and give satisfaction to his mother. It's a great sentiment. So how he achieves, he makes so many tricks, how does he gives all the adventures. Finally, he vanquishes the villains. While there is another person who is just romancing and other for us to fill it with duets, romantic scenes, jokes and all that, that other character will be sufficient. So if you got two roles, and this will work as a big commercial hit. Within immediately we all accepted it and we thanked him. Then we all worked on the script, and Crazy Mohan, Anantu, Kamal Hassan is there. We all worked the dwarf scenes and the main scenes and the villains, four villains, how they should be. It's a police officer, everything. But for me, as a director, what was more important for me was the responsibility of seeing the other character other than the dwarf, he also easily highlighted. Because I have seen previously this Kamal Hassan's Kalyan Raman. I went to Ooty when he was shooting, I saw the getup and immediately told Mr. Kamal Hassan and Panju Arunachalam, this will be a big hit. If you dub it in Telugu, there also it will be a big hit. It happened the same thing. When I saw the film, this was a great character and a very lovable character, and it was a highlight. But in the process, the other character, normal character, was totally a washout. Nobody bothered about that. Who, Kamal Hassan also acted that. But probably he sang some duet somewhere, some adventure. Nobody knows about it. When this Kalyan Raman dies at the interval point, they were all disappointed. Once he is gone, what is the other story left about? But when he came back as a ghost, then the interest revived. The electricity started getting in and they all enjoyed. It became a hit. This I remembered very much, and I did not want that mistake should be repeated in our Apoorva Sahodargal. We named it Apoorva Sahodargal because it's an old film with a double role, and usually Kamal Hassan, even in Leela, Sati Leelavati, he has got that idea. Supposing we take an old film's title, anchored by Mr. M.G. Ramachandran or some great stars of those days, then it will work immediately with the people. That was a sound calculation, commercial calculation. So we called it Apoorva Sahodargal. In Telugu it was dubbed as Vichitra Sahodargal, and in Hindi it was dubbed as Apuraja. And I saw when the script was there, though I was the director, unobtrusively, if this way, this is good, this is not good, I used to put cold reactions to other traits. Somehow, when I found, once the character is there and the situations are, I am sure Kamal Hassan will take it over. There is no problem. But there, you must create the base. You must create him the material. Only when the material is created, he can do. In Kalyan Raman, that material was not created. Raja kaiya vacha adu raga ponadille naan raja panni vacha vandi bejar pannadille perusu endralum sirusu endralum sogusu en velada tarapam pam inda raja kaiya vacha adu raga ponadille raja kaiya. So, when we want to have a fresh type of villain, the only way was, instead of casting an established big villain, cast a comparatively new person. He must be a brilliant actor also. and make him a villain, he has got a very good chance of appearing a big villain because it is going to be unexpected. Such ideas can come only in a brainstorming session. And for the Indian cinema script writing, brainstorming session, I think, is very essential, unlike the Hollywood pattern. In Hollywood, all scripts are written beforehand, 100. I also went there in Hollywood, they asked for 100 scripts. Everything, every small visual has to be given. And it has to be distributed within the cameraman, the sound people, the actors, everybody. So, in Hollywood, all scripts are written perfect. But here, though we have got very great writers, dialogue writers are there, story writers are there, but script writing is a scientific thing. It has to be very properly done. And most of the time, the directors write. And we are basically, our cinema has been born and brought up from the stage. Essentially, they are photographed stage plays. They are not cinema in the real sense, not using the cinema grammar and the cinema texture. So that sort of a visual presentation is not there. Thinking in terms of cinema as a language is not there. Just photographing a stage play is there. Because that's why in all our films, all the people stand in a group and they all talk in a full floor set, right from the black and white days. And the script writing is, essentially, we depend more on dialogues. So we have a separate title called dialogue writer. In West, you don't see, it's only a screenplay writer, script writer, that's all. It's a part of the script. Whereas here, dialogue is separate. So what happens when a writer is given a scenic order? They just fold the paper. And the right hand side, the dialogue writes. How brilliantly, dramatically he writes, that is the big script. And this side, the director keeps on long shots, close shot, trolley shot, just that's all. There is not the way of looking the cinema in a cinematic way. So that's how we are accustomed. So in such a circumstances, though in our school, so Kamala Hassan is there, I am there, Crazy Mohan is there, we all try to do visually, nothing like a brainstorming session. So in that brainstorming session, ideas will come up with proper acting, we act in the scenes. So that's how we are more clear about our cinema. At that stage, at that meeting, we got the name of Nagesh. The moment we got Nagesh, it was brilliant. At the same time, we started thinking, it was very novel. And finally, we decided on Nagesh, and what a brilliant actor. One of the greatest actors India has produced. I don't think he got those Padma Awards any time. Every lesser person got it, but not a really deserving person like Nagesh. Doesn't matter. They don't mean anything for such a brilliant actor. And he took it with very great happiness. And we developed the character in such a way that he took all the seriousness, the type of wig we made, the type of look he gave, the sinister look, the sinister face, the jaws, the cut, everything suited that. It is a different character altogether. It is not Nagesh the star acting upon role. It is the villain there. It is a character that has come. You don't see the star at all. Actually, in all my films, the film is bigger than the actor. How whatever be the star value, it's bigger. The film is bigger. That's why I am very careful to see. But I don't suggest that to artists. I very nicely, very tactfully see that the actor doesn't become bigger than the cinema. The most film is always bigger than the actor. That's why you see always. So that's how Nagesh was fixed. And one more role. Sri Vidya was mother and Manorama was there. Brilliant, no problem. And other small characters were there. One character which we wanted to is the father of these twins. Kamala Hassan twins. And Sri Vidya is the mother. And who should be the father? So Mr. Kamala Hassan said, why can't we have Mr. Prem Nazir? It's a novel thing, it's new for the Tamil screen. I said yes. So myself and Kamala Hassan, we went to Mr. Prem Nazir's house and we told him this is the subject. He was very thankful, he was glad, and he would be very happy to do it. But unfortunately, he was not doing well. He was very sick. So he was completely taken rest. Because of health reasons, I am not able to do this film, kindly excuse me. That's what Mr. Prem Nazir said. Then who should do?
எங்க அப்பா வேறதான் வைக்கணும் அப்பா துறை செல்லமா அப்பனுக்கு போடலாம்.
As far as the main, this Raja's character is getting jovial, they are all the traditional filmmaking, there is not much. Only thing is we have to get the dialogues bright, we have got to get the all the sequences and locales correctly, which we did. And most of the time we did it in that Indian Express stage, that court scenes and some of those things in that Coca-Cola gardens, very only here, some streets. But the dwarf's role we had to do only in a circus and outside the circus. And to keep the dwarf very convincing, we enrolled another three dwarfs in the script. So that there are four dwarfs. Those three are real dwarfs. So we made them act. And the totally Kamala Hassan is the fourth dwarf. So that everything will be real. So when he is walking, other dwarfs walk. Their realism is unconsciously included in that. So we did that and circus. The circus, we booked it in Cochin. There is a circus for us. Because we cannot ask a circus to come here for our whim and fancy. A circus was running in Cochin. So Mr. DNS, the production manager, went there. He is a great production manager, great executive. Not just a production, he is a great executive, he is almost a producer. The way, the calmness with which he organizes everything is unbelievable. Very great executive. And he went there, organized everything and came back. The entire troupe went in the circus. But the work was so voluminous and we had so many ideas to cover, especially with dwarf. The time consuming preparations needed to picturize the dwarf, we could not finish that. So after doing all that work, we again recreated a part of that in a tent here. Thota Tharani was the art director. And Thota Tharani did, as you know, very wonderful. After Rajaparvai, this is the Rajkamal production he was doing. He was doing already many productions after that. So he did a part of the tent. And slowly we wanted only some dog and one lion and two camels. Almost half the circus came from Cochin to here. We could have as well built the entire set, circus set here, and we could have done. All that happened only because Mr. Kamala Hassan was the producer. I don't think any other producer would have done it. Because he was the producer, Raj Kamal Films were the producers. Because he had the passion to do it. So it was not the money. Money is important. We have to get back the money. But finally, what we thought in the script has to be realized on the screen. And Kamala Hassan's passion for the film, it was what drove the entire film to them. Or else, who will go to the circus? They will say, sir, you have got only 20 days or 15 days. Only that permission, you kindly finished off to do it in the nights or somehow compromise, take some close-up somewhere. All that they will tell. But he rebuilt the whole thing here and we shot very comfortably. So this is the set work. And now comes the main thing, the technique of the dwarf. This has been the talking point for all their country, because in all the three languages it's a big hit. And everybody telling, in those days when graphics were not there, you were able to do it. Two things. One is all mechanics and the great effort put in by Mr. Kamal Haasan, because it is a physical pain to do that. It is not easy. It is not just sitting in a caravan in an air-conditioned room and coming for the shot when it is needed. He has to be there throughout through the rehearsals. So that was there. So these two things combined. For the script was there to given. So the first start is, and we did not have a monitors those days. The only we had to put a video camera almost next to the camera and shoot the same height and see how it worked. We saw in the video and checked what was. It's all in shot in film, no digital those days. So what exactly is going to happen, we could show only in the video. Fortunately, video had come by that time. There was no problem, no CG, no digital filmmaking. And first thing was how Kamala Haasan performance when he is standing. For that, special shoes were prepared with goes up the knees. So it opens from behind. So you know, leg means you can put like that. How you put a shoe for the knee? So it is a different thing, opening from behind and comes. Finally, it looks like a shoe and it is put for the knee. And the whole person is buried knee deep and everything is covered with sand. So when you see, he is standing there. There is no problem. You can crane, you can take a crane shot from down, you can trolley around, but he is static. Everybody will be going around, but he is static. So that was the simplest we could do. Suddenly we found his hands were normal. He was just like that, down. All hands were down and he is doing like that. And now the dwarf, only the height have we have reduced, but not in reality, a bit of hands also will be reduced. It is not possible. So we missed that. When we actually saw in the video, we have all managed, planned everything, how to reduce the height. And we thought the dwarf is made. But the dwarf also has got a slight, if you see the hands, it will be proportionate to that height. It will not be. It will be no more like orangutan. It will be like an ape. That will have a sharp thing and will be long hands. That sort of a look was there. Then how to do? Mr. Kamala Haasan had an idea. So he said, only when we give this, immediately people will say, oh, this man has got long hands and a short feet. So he kept his hands like that, and as a mannerism, he had these two hands like that, as though he is a sort of a sando. He is doing like that, and this avoided showing the length of the hand. He made it a mannerism. Always he comes like that, he walks like that, he jumps like that, he sings like that. Throughout the hands are like that. This is to avoid that oddity, so that people are convinced about the dwarf. This is how manage the hands. The hand position was very important and Kamala Haasan maintained that. Of course, once we got the idea, there is no problem. He will maintain it. There are people to remind him, continue, everything is there. That is a physical struggle. But he kept that hands like that and made a part of the character. That was Kamala Haasan's effort as an actor. So that was there. Now the problem comes when he is walking. How can he, a man who is dug and completely buried, how can he walk? So we had to, it is exactly 18 inches when you find from the 18 inches from the foot to the knee, it was 18 inches. This was exactly calculated. And a pit, lengthy pit was dug, like that it goes. And Kamala Haasan is walking in that pit. It is not buried. You cannot put mud because Kamala Haasan cannot walk. Now, from here, eye level, if you see, the pit will be seen. Therefore, to make it look real, the camera has to be placed in another pit, equally 18 feet, what the length required for the camera, to put it for 18 inches, so that the surface of the land on this side and that side, they merge. The pit is not seen. They are all in one perspective. So when Kamala Haasan is walking, it looks as though he is walking on the land. on the floor because the pit is submerged in that perspective. So camera is placed in that. So this is also dug 18 inches, big enough for a trolley to go. Suppose you, because if you to pan, then somewhere the it will be shown off, the pit will be shown. So exactly the same perspective it has to trolley. So enough pit to dig and to put a trolley, put a camera and people to go about, persons to sit, all that amount of pit has to be there.
பாட்டு படிச்சே தங்கமே ஞான தங்கமே, என்ன நினைச்சே நானும் சிரிச்சே தங்கமே ஞான தங்கமே. அந்த வானம் அழுதாத்தா இந்த பூமியே சிரிக்கும், வானம் போல் சில பேர் சொந்த வாழ்க்கையும் இருக்கும். உணர்ந்தே உன்ன நினைச்சே பாட்டு படிச்சே தங்கமே ஞான தங்கமே, என்ன நினைச்சே நான் சிரிச்சே தங்கமே ஞான தங்கமே.